Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mpumile Dwaba. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you to everybody who likes, everybody who comments, and everybody who subscribed. The consistency and the love is so overwhelming. To those who are new to my channel, please like, comment, and subscribe. I appreciate it. Today, I want to talk about what do you have in your hands. And this is a topic based on so many times we just really don't know where to start. Like, I know so many people who have so many brilliant ideas, who want to do so many great things, but you just really, really don't know where to start. You're just overwhelmed by everything around you, and you're just like, but I don't even have the resources, I don't have this, I don't have that. And I think the number one cause of that is we look at our dreams with such a great vision, which is a great thing, by the way, but it's so big that when you look in your hands, you're like, there's no way I can achieve that. So I know I've told my story, but I will always refer back to my story so I can personalize it, so that I don't always talk about people who we read in books about, because sometimes when it's someone who's far away, like Oprah or whatever, it can be a bit unbelievable, like, and we can be like, but that's Oprah. So I like to use my story, my personal story, because I'm just normal like everybody, around everyone, so that you can see that it's actually possible to slowly make your dreams come true. And that's not to say, oh, my dreams have come true. This is my foundation, my Bible, which is falling apart. My mom got me this Bible when I was I've got the date. In 2008, I've got four other Bibles in the house, but this is like, yeah, this is like my everything. So this is where I basically, this is the word is obviously the foundation of my life, or rather, every answer I need, I try to get it from the word. So I came across this book, 2 Kings chapter 4, where Elisha helps a poor widow. I'm gonna read chapter 1 and verse 1 and 2. One day, the widow of a member of the group of prophets came to Elisha and cried out, "My husband who served you is dead, and you know how he feared the Lord. But now a creditor has come, threatening to take my two sons as slaves." "What can I do to help you?" Elisha asked. "Tell me, what do you have in the house?" "Nothing at all, except a flask of olive oil," she replied. Sure. So this widow now has just lost her husband, and obviously she doesn't work, she doesn't have anything, and she goes to Elisha, telling Elisha that, you know what, now what I depended on is now gone, and all I have left, and I've got nothing left. And that's the basis of many miracles, that our dependency goes away. Like, let's say you lose your job, and you just, it's one of those situations when you go to God and say, "God, I've lost my job," or "I've lost my father," or "I've lost my husband," or I've lost my passion at work. And that's your dependency, that one thing that you depend on. What do I do now? Because if this thing does not resurrect, or if this thing does not work out, I'm gonna die. I've got nothing else to live for. And Elisha comes to her, and he doesn't say, here's a penny, or here's $10 or whatever. He says, "What do you have in your hand?" And I think that's just the relationship God has with us. God will never come to us and say, once we've lost something, or he's rather closed the door, he won't say, "Oh well, since this door's closed now, here, take this million rand, go and make a living." No, God will always ask you, "What do you have in your hand?" And what did she have? She had a flask of olive oil. I'm going to carry on. Chapter 3. And Elisha said, "Borrow as many empty jars as you can from your friends and neighbors. Then go into your house with your sons and shut the door behind you." And this goes to saying, when Elisha asked her to go borrow from neighbors, this just popped in my head that most times when we lose things, or when we go into a time of trouble, we like to isolate ourselves and turn from family, turn from friends, or turn from even God and our husbands, because we want to be isolated. And that's exactly where the enemy wants us. He wants us in isolation, where I think in most cases, And I'm no expert in depression, but I'd like to think that's one of the biggest causes of depression, or what leads to depression, or what leads to self-esteem issues. Isolation, because you're now drowning in your thoughts because you don't know what to do because you've lost something that meant so much to you. So Elijah says, go borrow from your neighbors and your friends. And that's to say, never isolate yourself. And Elisha said, borrow as many empty jars as you can from your friends and neighbors. Then go into your house with your sons and shut the door behind you. Pour olive oil from your flask into the jars, setting each one aside when it is filled. So she did as she was told. Her sons kept bringing jars to her, and she filled one after another. Soon, every container was full to the brim. Bring me another jar, she said to one of her sons. There aren't any more, he told her. And then the olive oil stopped flowing. When she told the man of God what had happened, he said to her, now sell off the olive oil and pay your debts, and you and your sons can live on what is left over. What does that word say? Is God will give you instruction, and he will ask you, what do you have in your hand? Use that in your hand to multiply, and use that in your hand to bring something even greater in your life. You know, and that's what exactly what the woman did. She took the instruction of Elisha, and she took the olive oil that she had, and she kept filling and filling and filling until there was no more, and there was an overflow, and she sold that. And that's where the miracle was. The miracle, which brings me to what I'm trying to talk about, is the miracle is what you have in your hand. And I like to tell the story. Many people ask how I started my business. Like I said, I went to a nail school without even knowing anything about nails. And I studied. And when I applied for jobs, no one took me. Everyone rejected me. And that's the death of my dependency. Like, she lost her husband. And this is not to compare, but this is just to kind of bring it closer to home. I lost what I thought was going to supply for me, you know, which was a stable job. And God said, what do you have in your hand? And all I had was a skill. I said, God, I have a skill. And honestly, that's the only thing I've got right now. And God said, use that. And that's exactly what I did. I used my skill on family, got better at what I do, used my skill on friends, went to my friends' houses, took my car, drove to clients, messed up here and there. But I was using, pouring my oil into the jars, the borrowed jars, the jars of friends, the jars of family, using my oil, pouring my skill, until eventually I had enough to open my business, to have four walls and open my business. And that's just exactly what happened with her. So how can you apply this into your circumstance? What do you have? And you know what? In the process of all of this, it sounds like, oh, that was such an easy story. In the process of this, it's never easy. But it's always important to always, in the moment, do the best you can. Because I think sometimes what tends to distract us as people is that you're always looking at, oh my gosh, what's going to happen next month? Oh my gosh, what if I don't get a client tomorrow? Oh my gosh, what if I don't make rent next month? The important thing is today, you've got rent. Today, you've got a client. And everything you do today, do as unto the Lord. Do it with love. Focus on today and do the best today. Use what's in your hand today the best way you can. And yeah, and that's to say, for most people with who are in business or even in the workplace who are trying to get a promotion, advice how to get your promotion, how to get your business going, as most people would ask me, how did I get clients in my business? And what I'll say is, let your work speak for you. And that's the best form of marketing. A form of marketing is word of mouth and letting your work speak for you. So with me, social media has played a huge impact in my business, and that's kind of what I have in my hands. Social media. I don't have money for radio adverts or whatever. What I do have is data and a cell phone, social media, and pictures, and that's exactly what I used. And then while reaching the ones I have reached with social media, I do the best that I can, using my skill. And those people go out there and they speak, and eventually everybody will know, you know. So even with a promotion, you don't have to wait until someone says, hi guys, there's a post. Prove yourself while you're at the bottom. I was talking to somebody, and I don't want to mention name, and they were complaining, saying, yeah, I do so much work and I deserve so much more money and what. And I said to them, you know what, Don't pull out your seeds before harvest time. don't be in a rush to make demands. Don't be in a rush to say, you know what, I've sown my potatoes here, I've sown here, I put in all the hard work, but nothing is happening, and blah, blah, blah. Imagine pulling out your seeds a day before harvest. Imagine quitting a day before getting a promotion because you failed to be patient and you failed to do the best in that season. So that's just to say, whatever you have in your hand, whatever season you're in, make use of your skill, make use of what you have in your hand to the best of your ability. Man will sort out for you. And we were watching a sermon by Pastor Mike Todd, and he spoke about David, and that's one guy who knew how to use what was in his hand. David was trained, before David was king, he was already trained, and he was already working as unto the Lord, doing his best efforts. David killed a bear, David killed a lion, and I'd like to think he probably used a stone and a sling, or whatever resources were around him. And that's why when it was time to kill Goliath, which was his big moment now, his time to shine, he did not go and pick up a sword, or ask for, hey guys, can I borrow a gun, or whatever resources were available. What did he use? He used his sling and his stone, and he used exactly what was in his hand, and that's how he defeated the enemy. And that's where your breakthrough is at. What do we have in your hands? What do you have that God has given to you? What is it that you have that nobody else has? Use that. And yeah, I hope this made sense. I know I rambled a lot. I jumped here and there. But the most important thing I wanted to get to is the common denominator of successful people is that they did the best where they started. They used what they had. We were listening to, I forgot this guy's name, my husband will mention it. And he said, many people want to have want to be on television, want to be on radio, and blah, blah, blah. And the first thing they will check for people who come for like auditions is, what have you done on YouTube? What have you done on podcasts or whatever, on your social media? Is there any way that shows that you are actually interested in this line of business? You know, I think gone are the times where we sit back and wait for opportunity. Gone are the times where we sit back and wait for somebody to say, hey, it's time now. But now we have to do what we can. The internet is our resource. We've got so many resources around us. We've got people around us. We just have to use what we have. I can only speak for myself where I say, what I have is a mouth to talk. What I have is hand skill. What I have is a brain, and that's what I can use, you know? And I may not have a maths brain. That's why I didn't go be an actuarial scientist. But I use my brain for what's in line with me. And if you've got a maths brain, I don't know, use it, do that. But stay in your lane and use what's in your hand. Don't use what's in your neighbor's hand, you know? Use what's in your hand. And it just goes back to what I said about David, that he didn't go borrow some stuff to fight Goliath. He used his sling because that's what he was used to. That's what he knew. That's what he used in his moment of being hidden, and that's what he used in his moment of glory. So I think that's just how God is. God won't let you shine with somebody else's while you're trying to be somebody else. God lets you shine in who you are. The answers are in the Word. I personally find answers for my business in the Word, answers for my marriage in the Word, answers for whatever I'm going through or whatever I need wise counsel for. It's in the Word. And also in using what you have, I guess it's in line with sowing seeds and whatever. Like I was saying, do everything that you do as though you do it unto the Lord. And don't forget to give back to God. So I hope this message touched somebody. I hope it has made a difference to you. If you want to start that business, start it, girl. Start it, sir. Even if it means you started in your bedroom. But you cannot sell to the world if you can't sell to your neighborhood. If your neighborhood does not know what you're doing, how do you expect the world to know? You know? My husband, who's a musician, when he was young, he used to make music and recorded with a voice note. And when he'd go to school, he'd send it via infrared or Bluetooth. And this is like long time ago when he was still in school. And that was him sowing his seeds. That was him using what he has in his hand, because he could have sat and said, oh no, but I need to go to Joburg. He's from Mpumalanga, by the way. Oh no, I need to go to Joburg and get in a studio and record, and that's going to kickstart my music career. No, he started with what he had. And I love to tell the story because I think it's so inspiring. He started with his phone, or his friends listened to his music, and that is sowing his seeds. That's him using what's in his hand. So I'm gonna ask you, before I close this conversation, or rather this topic, what do you have in your hand? What are you doing with what you have in your hand? Are you working, or are you using it as though you're using it as unto the Lord? Or are you throwing away your talents? Are you throwing away your gifts? Are you throwing away and sitting on what you have? So yeah, thank you guys for joining me. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe, to leave a comment, to like, and also you can suggest other topics you'd like me to talk about. I'm done. Brendan. Another night.